بچه‌ها از ذره چیز این کارو نشوز نکنید.
Het keizerlijk paleis in Noord-Teheran wordt bewaakt door gewapende burgers. De nieuwe wacht staat onder de leiding van twee priesters. De keizer der keizers is verslagen door de mensen die hij rijkdom en vooruitgang had beloofd.
Imam Khomeini, Khomeini, Ruhollah. Ruhollah, Ruhollah, Salah. Isa Ruhollah, Muhammad Rasulullah, Ali Salih.
Iran, 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 Rajbar Musalsal Ha. Iran, 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 Rajbar Musalsal Ha. Iran, 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 Mushte Shade Bar Eyvan, Mushte Shade Bar Eyvan. Iran, 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 Rajbar Musalsal Ha, Mushte Shade Bar Eyvan.
I'm a housewife, you know, I can't, I don't have so much idea about the politics, but what I feel, Ayatollah Khomeini is a great man. He was the only man, he could stand up and say something about the Shah, and which nobody could do that. And of course, I believe him as a religious man too.
Khomeini en de zijnen willen de macht van de regering Bakhtiar breken en het leger uitschakelen. Het oude regime van de Shah heeft de mensen hun persoonlijke en politieke vrijheid ontnomen en dat is tegen de principes van de Shiiten. En de wortels van die godsdienst zitten diep.
In our family they were religious people. And in Islam they say everybody is the same. Man and a woman and a child and a black and a white. So it can't be no different between people.
Are you still religious?
Well, not that much praying every minute and every day, but I believe in what they, I believe what some of the things they teach me.
So the basic things in Islam, you think they are right?
Of course they are right. Because in Islam, they, I, like I said, there's no difference between black, white and, I mean, between man and a woman. Everybody's in the same. Everybody's in the same situation.
De Universiteit van Teheran. Dit is het centrum van alle politieke strekkingen die zich sedert een half jaar hebben vrijgevochten. De Shah heeft alle moeite gedaan om jonge mensen te laten studeren hier en in het buitenland. Maar de studenten zijn zijn hevigste tegenstanders geworden. En zo is het gegaan met veel van de geforceerde plannen van de Shah. Iedereen moest het met het regime eens zijn en de dwang joeg de mensen in het andere kamp. Het symbool voor die dwang was de geheime politie, de SAVAK.
They had here everywhere and everybody, or they they advertised like that. They said we have out of 10 or 9, I don't know, one was working for them. Therefore, everybody afraid of talking with the with somebody which he doesn't know him.
So anyone, could be anyone?
Could be anyone.
In
could
your
be,
own family?
Even in my family, mm. Yes.
So before you didn't talk about politics?
Not at all.
Not in your family?
No, not at all. Mm. And even my parents, they didn't know what is my idea about opposition or the previous regime or the any other political idea. They didn't know until recently we sat down and started to discuss with my parents and then the others.
Zo was Iran jarenlang een land met een masker op. Het gezicht van dat land waren de rijke wijken in het noorden van Teheran tegen de bergen aangebouwd, een monsterlijke stad. Hier is geen rekening gehouden met wat bestond of met tradities en gewoonten. Hier woont de internationale jetset die zich in New York of Los Angeles waant.
Of course it's a nice life, you know, to have a nice home and the pool and good food and everything. But it's not for everybody. We have to think of 35 million people. If you think about it, maybe 1 million of the Iran people living like an American or the European life and very best life. But I don't think it's right for the people who are dying from hunger in the south of Tehran and the people who are giving the steak to their own dogs and treating them best way.
In het zuiden waar het open rioolsysteem van de stad uitmondt, wonen de armste mensen van Teheran. Boeren die failliet gingen en in de stad hun geluk beproeven. Mensen die te arm zijn om hun huishuur te betalen. Dit verwacht je eigenlijk niet in een schatrijk land.
We should have the best country. We should have the best infrastructure, supplies, the telephone, and then, you know, the roads and the hospitals and then the schools and everything. But now we don't have that much. What happened to that? Since it is my profession and I was in the spot, I know a little bit that, for instance, we paid one-third of it, almost $25 billion for weapons, which we Iranians, we believe that it was unnecessary for us. We don't want to be gendarme in outside when we don't have anything inside to eat it. First we need hospitals, food, and then, you know, our agriculture industry to grow. And then later, if we get enough, we organize our economy and then we can turn to buy weapons from the outside. And the second was the money they paid it for the loan for other countries like...
Iran lending money to other countries?
Yes, it did. Yes, yeah, yeah. Around $10 billion. $10 billion.
To rich countries, in fact?
British.
So it was not to Bangladesh or to...
No, to rich people. And it was, I think that was a part of agreement between the government and then the Western or, you know, the rich countries that they have to return back. The increase in the prices and the oil income, it has to be returned to their country somehow. And then the remaining, what was it in Iran? The Iranian rich people, they got it. Or, you know, they had it, we call it 1,000 family. They are the biggest, you know, the 1,000 family which they owed everything. They buy the rest of it. What is remaining for the country, for the people, is the mess, which we have to just rebuild again the country. We have to take care of that one.
از تظاهرات هم می‌دونم.